Alright, so how you guys doing? So yeah, man. So this is a tutorial, so it's not a remake or whatever you might be looking for. It's a tutorial on linking parameters, you know. So I'll show you guys how to link parameters. I don't know what's happening here. Let me check something. So I'll show you guys how to link parameters. For those of you that don't know what that's basically just linking your plugins to whatever hardware you might actually have, and then instead of having to use your cursor or your mouse to control different things, you just use your thing. You use the hardware that you have. So unfortunately, I don't have I can't show you guys my MIDI controller, but I'm using a MIDI controller. It's an M Audio Key Studio, the 49 keys one. And yeah, there's nothing else special about it. It's just got one cable plugged in, and that's all there is. So I'll show you guys how to basically link a certain parameter on your plugin to whatever hardware you might have, and then manually control that using your hands instead of having to use your mouse, you know. So let's open up a plugin. Let's open up the silent plugin. So yeah, so you have your plugin like this, right? So let me quickly load the bank. I don't know why I have to do this all the time now. The previous time I had this thing, this plugin, like the banks were just like preloaded every time I opened it up. So if you know how to do that, how to fix that up, let me know. But yeah, so let's continue the topic though. I'll probably fix it by the end of today. Okay, so let me check the time. All right, so what you have is you have your plugin. So let's say you have your song now, and maybe you want to do some live recording on your song. So you want to play your it's not picking up my MIDI controller. There you go. So you have your, see, that's our sound. So now let's say you want to, so that's how your sound, that's how that sound sounds, like that's how that sound sounds right now. So let's say you want to be able to, while pressing the key, let's say I'm gonna press C5 there. So while I'm pressing C5, I want to be able to shift the cutoff point like this here. Understand, I want to be able to do that, but I don't want to have to jump around between pressing on my MIDI controller and, you know, using my keypad and my mouse to click and hold and drag this thing around like this. What if I could link this to some button on my MIDI controller, and then while I'm pressing the keys, I just use that button to shift it up and down. So for those of you that don't know, you can go through and Google it. It's M Audio Key Studio. It's the 49 keys one. And if you look at it, if you check it out on Google, you find that it has like all the keys. Then it's got like two joggles. It's got the pitch bend, and it's got the modulation one. So what I will do is I'll link this to the modulation joggle on my MIDI controller. So what that will do is that I don't have to use my mouse or to move this thing around the way I'm clicking and holding right now like that, but I can simply just move my joggle. I don't know if you guys can hear it like that. You see, nothing's moving, but I'm actually moving around. I can simply move my joggle, and this part will move as well. So that's basically what linking parameters is. You're just linking whatever you have here to a certain button on your instrument or whatever you might have with you that you connected to your PC. And then every time you control that button with your hand, it's going to move this particular control or button or knob or whatever it is on that particular plugin. So there's a lot of ways of doing it. So I'll show you the first way that I found, which is quite a long route. You can go to and say browse parameters, and then what it will do is it'll show you all these things, all the things that you see here. Are pretty much all the buttons that are here. These are all the things that you can link onto whatever instrument you're using. So everything that you see here is probably somewhere around here, how do you see that, like all these beginning things, all the first names there, AMP, A attack. So that's AMP envelope A attack. Then you just look for AMP, there's NV, there's A. Then you just say, okay, that's probably the attack or whatever there is. I don't know. Let's check. Yeah, it is. So that's the attack. That's the decay. See this? It's got the letters there, D, decay, release. You got your R there. You got your sustain. You got your S. So everything that's here is also here, and just in a name form. So what you want to do is you want to look for the one that you want to link to your instrument. So I want to link this cutoff thing here to my instrument, which is a modulation juggle on my thing, on my M Audio Key Studio MIDI controller. So what I'll do is I'll look for the subheading, which is filter control, and then I'll obviously look for this part here, which is cutoff point or cutoff whatever. So we're gonna look here. What you're looking for is you're looking for filter control. So obviously it's not anywhere there. You got filter there, filter A, that's there. So it should be near filter A because it's right next to each other. So we look for filter A, filter B, and you have filter control there. Filter control. It's not written in full like here, but CTR is control. So you can see you got filter control cutoff, filter control resonance there, filter control key track there, filter control warm drive there. So you wanna link this one, which is the cutoff, this one here, to the juggle. You see, I'm moving my juggle right now and nothing's happening. But watch, as soon as I right click on this, I'm gonna say right click. That's how you do it actually. You right click on this, right click, link to controller. As soon as it pops up like that, you don't have to do anything. Literally, once it pops up like this, you then go to whatever button, whatever it is that you're linking it to, and you just move it and you press it or you do whatever you must do. So if it's a small knob that you just rotate up and down, you do that. If it's a juggle, in this case, I'm just gonna move it. I'm gonna touch it, and automatically this box is gonna go away. As you can see, I'm gonna put my cursor right here in the corner so that you see that I'm not touching my cursor right now. There it is the whole time. But watch, as soon as I touch, I'm going to touch my modulation juggle now, and this part here will vanish, and the cutoff key will start moving. But you can keep tabs on my thing. I wish I had like a camera where I can show you guys what I'm actually doing, but I don't have it, so you just have to trust me on this and just watch the cursor. There's a cursor there, top right corner. So I'm moving my juggle now in 3, 2, 1, go. I just did that. You see that? The cursor's still there. Now I've moved my juggle. Now watch the cutoff point. You see the cursor's still there at the top left corner. I'm gonna leave it there. Watch the cutoff point. Watch this part here now. So watch there. You see how now it's automatically moving on its own. As I move the juggle like that, it's also moving. So now what I can do is I can press a key without using my cursor anymore, which I'll leave there the whole time. Like that, I'll leave it there. Sorry. I'll leave it there. And all of, what am I doing? So all I'll do is I'll just press the key that I was pressing earlier on, which is C5, like that. And then I'm moving, and then I'm gonna move my modulation wheel, my juggle, like up and down, so you guys can see it. You see that? And that's all there is, really. Like, that's pretty much all there is. What else you want to do? In terms of choosing where you link it to, I think obviously you just go based on which one you see is the most ideal one. I mean, you don't want to link it to a button that you don't know how you're gonna move it up and down like that. So you want to choose something that you can see that its motion as well. In general, it's going to move it up and down like that. You also got a volume part here, which I could also link it to, which is the volume one. It's not a juggle, it's just like a mini volume knob on my Key Studio, which I could drag up and down. It almost looks like this here. So I could easily link one of these, because it pretty much looks like this. I could link one of these to the volume knob because I'm moving it up and down. So I'll do that for you guys. I'll do that, but in doing that, I'll show you the second way, the quick and easy way of doing it, instead of having to go and say browse and all that stuff there. I'll just go here and I'll say link all parameters. And then when this box pops up, remember this box that popped up when you say link parameter? This is the same box. So now you're just gonna say click on that. Okay, let me say escape. So we're looking for env env a, and we want to link the s one. We want to link the s, this thing, the sustain one, to the volume knob that we have. So let's do that. So looking for env, and then link the sustain. So we're linking it now by doing that. You see, done. Then we say accept. I think that should do the job. Let's see what happens. There it is. You see. So I'm moving it down now, and I'm moving it up now. You see, and my juggle should still have been linked to the cutoff point. So you see now I've got different buttons linked to different things. I've got the juggle linked to the cutoff point, to the cutoff thing filter control. I've got the sustain linked there. I could control the two things at the same time, move them both in different directions, up and down like that. You see, I'm doing all of that at the same time, which is something that you can't do using your mouse. You know, if you're using your mouse, you would have to control this one first, put it at the certain point, come back and drag this one up, put it at the certain point, and then continue like that. Whereas with this, you can control two things at once, as you can see. Cutoff point, sustain. Cutoff point, sustain. So that's pretty much it, man. That's pretty much how you link all parameters. I mean, I'm pretty sure that's the same. It's the same concept with everything else. I don't think there should be any changes in terms of plugins and stuff. You just do it the same because all plugins have that link parameter thing. But let's check it out. Let's see with let's try hypersonic. Let's see what we get with hypersonic. Okay. So we're gonna come here, we're gonna say okay, browse parameters. So you see you got hypersonic, you got the parameters there, and let's see what does it have. Pitch mode, tuning one scale, wada 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 wada. Doesn't really have much. Most of the things in hypersonic are probably things from here. Sorry, from where? So you find that it's actually from. So it's all these things here. So like you got all these knobs that you can control here, you know. So you probably want to control those. I'm not very familiar with this side of hypersonic, so I hardly deal with it a lot. I don't use it that much, so I don't want to try stuff that I don't know. Not in the video, at least. I'll try that by myself, and once I know it, then I'll come back and I'll teach you guys. But it's pretty much the same thing, man. You're just linking parameters, you're just linking and linking, and it's still linked even now. I'll show you. See, you don't have to worry about it unlinking, you know. That's pretty much it, and yeah, okay, so. General information. I think this is where the difference in terms of MIDI controllers, which one you buy, which one you don't buy, all those things. This is where the difference comes in, because as you can see, my jog will. Well, you can't see that, but I can see it. Like the pace that I move my modulation jog will is not the same as this one here. There's a bit of a lag period. By the time I move it up like this, it's already like this is just like way beyond, you know. Sometimes it's too fast, sometimes it's too slow, all those kind of things. You see with the sustain thing there, I'm moving it down already, but it's moving at a slower pace than my hand is. So it could kind of give you it could kind of like mess up with your pace, man. I mean, if you feel like you're almost at the top and it's just not it's far from the top, that could kind of like fuck you up a bit. But that's pretty much it. There's nothing else to it, man. So that I think that's where the difference comes in terms of brands, which brand you wanna buy. If you're buying a MIDI controller, maybe a different brand has a quicker reaction the response reaction response time with the plugins and stuff. It also depends on your RAM, you know. So there's a lot of factors and your processor and stuff. So there's a lot of factors into why there might be this delay here, you know, between me moving my thing, my jog wheel, and it moving itself here. So there's a lot of factors. I can't just say it's on the brand. It could also be your RAM, could also be your thing, just a general computer and stuff. So yeah, you know, that's basically it. So I think if you want to go buy a MIDI controller, some of the things you might want to look at and see which is best, which is ideal. the response time in terms of keys, when you press the key and when the actual plugin actually responds to you pressing the key, all those kind of things. You might want to look into that. What else is there? That's pretty much it, man. Like, I don't know what else is there. If you have questions, just drop them in the comment section. I'll try to respond. I kind of take a lot of time to respond to questions, but I do respond as soon as I can. I respond quick on my Facebook page and the website, so you can go there, check out the description box. There's a link to my website and my Facebook page on my website, and then just hit me up there. I respond quicker, you know. Plugins, if you want this plugin or any other plugin that I've shown on, or you've seen on the videos, go through to the website, free stuff, brackets, downloads. There's a Dropbox link. The Dropbox link has all the Fruity Loop files, the project files, the plugins, drum packs, sound packs, drum kits, everything that you might need that I've used on the videos. It should be there on the Dropbox link. So, you know, you don't have to worry about going and looking for me and searching for me and trying to find out where you can find this plugin. Just check the description box of this video. There's a link. In that link, take you to my website. Under my website, the menu tab or the front page, you should find the free stuff, free downloads. There's a Dropbox link. That's the link that has everything for you. Yeah, man, that's pretty much it. Any questions, just hit me up. If there's something that I missed, I'm sorry. Otherwise, yeah, man, like, subscribe, comment, Facebook, Twitter, SoundCloud, follow, all that jazz there. Shap, shap, my fits.